this video, we are going to discuss about that what are the physiological changes that are going to happen when astronaut goes into the space. So let's start. The first is cosmic radiation. When astronaut goes in the space, there are lot many cosmic radiations present. Due to the effect of cosmic radiation, our brain, our neurons, which has demyelinating sheets, are undergoes into degeneration. And there are lot many chances that astronaut can suffer with the neurodegenerative disease like epilepsy, dementia and all that. The second is cardiovascular system. When we are on the earth, our heart and gravity works together to supply blood to our lower limbs. How? Heart pumps blood outward and gravity assists by pulling blood downwards towards the lower limb. But when we are in the space, there is no gravity to assist blood circulation. So what happens? All the bloods and excessive fluids goes upwards towards the face and accumulate around the face. Due to this effect, astronauts suffer from the puffy face syndrome. You can see on the picture that astronaut has swelling and redness around the face. Due to effect of puffy face syndrome, they suffer from the dizziness, vitiligo, headache and many more complications. The third is our musculoskeletal system. So we all know that what happens when the patient is completely bedridden on the earth. There are changes like muscle weakness, decrease in bone density, and eventually the muscle goes into atrophy. Same thing happens with the astronaut. When they are in the space, they have reduced muscle activity. So eventually the muscle goes into weakness, and after some time it goes into muscle atrophy. And we all know, on Earth, we have anti-gravity muscles that are working continuously to maintain our static erect posture. But when we are in the space, their anti-gravity muscle goes into rest, relaxation. They have no work to perform. So that muscle also goes into muscle atrophy. Due to reduction in muscle activity, the astronaut will lose muscle mass of lower limb like quadriceps, hamstring, and most important, our calf, because calf is known as second heart. And due to these musculoskeletal changes, astronaut will develop flex posture. Eventually, it will develop flex posture due to weak anti-gravity muscles, center of gravity shifted to backwards and all that. The next is increase in the height. Yes, you heard it right. And if you want to increase your height, join the space program. But how? As we all know that when we sleep in the nights, our intervertebral disc expand because there is no gravitational force to compress intervertebral discs. Same things happens with the astronaut. When they are on the space, there is no gravity, so no intervertebral disc compression. So their disc expand and their height increases. But with this, their mobility of spine will also increase. And as we all know that nothing comes for free, we gain mobility as a cost of stability of our spine. So because of that, when astronauts return to the earth, they have conditions like back pain, PIVD and all that, because we lost our stability due to increase in mobility. The next is space sickness. It is kind of motion sickness. It happens because what we see doesn't match with what we feel. These all are the physiological changes that are going to happen when astronaut goes into the space. We are covering the astronaut training program in our next video. If you enjoyed this video, please give a like. And if you find this topic interesting and new, share this video with your friends. And also, if you have any doubts, you can ask in the comment box. And don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel.